At X-Ray's Barbershop in Essex Junction, Vermont, Patty Wells and Trish Cook hear all the town news and gossip, including rumors about the IBM plant down the street, the state's largest for-profit employer.
We hear it probably on a monthly basis that they're talking about laying off people.
And this week, the rumors prove to be true. IBM is laying off roughly 100 employees, 5 months after laying off 180, and 3 months after reducing the pay of some of its workers.
With 100 here, and then the last layoff they had, and then the one before, it's getting down to very few people.
The company says the layoffs affect temporary manufacturing employees hired for 1 to 3 years as part of a flexible workforce. An IBM spokesperson tells us this is in response to changing business requirements. These positions, he says, tend to fluctuate.
In the early part of the decade, the IBM facility here in Essex Junction employed about 8,500 people. But layoffs since then have brought that number down to about 5,400. And that has many here wondering, what's next?
Those people are who just keep hoping every day that they'll make it till their retirement.
You don't usually get triple digits in layoffs in Vermont because we just don't have very many firms of that size. And whenever it does happen, it's big news.
Art Wolf, associate professor of economics at the University of Vermont, sees this round of layoffs in a larger context: a slowing economy, decreased demand for many products, and rising unemployment rates.
So we've lost roughly 1,000 jobs over the last year. Percentage-wise, it's relatively small, but 1,000 jobs is still 1,000 jobs in a small state like Vermont.
He anticipates there will be more layoffs across the state and more fodder for discussion among Vermont lawmakers.
Economic issues are going to dominate the legislature come January.
And you want to get the mustache off the lip?
Meanwhile, many in Essex worry about the future of IBM.
The morale of the people that did work there is very bad.
And about what more layoffs could do to this community. In Essex Junction, Anya Hunneke, News Channel 5.